Prime Minister Narendra Modi, while addressing the commanders' conferences of all three forces, Air Force, Army and Navy, to prepare for a battle with invisible enemy. Interestingly, Modi advised to the armed forces come close on the heels of most heated discussions on a national TV channel the previous day. In that debate, senior BJP leader Govindachari, whom many consider as most level-headed person, was seen fuming and fretting Pakistan general ill-found claims. Govindachari went to the extent of warning Pakistani counterparts, any misadventure hereafter under Narendra Modi's dispensation, India would ensure that Pakistan doesn't cease on world map. He also poo-pooed that nuclear nation threats and claimed India has counter-strategy to counter such initiatives from neighbours. Many who watched Govindachari were fully convicted what was thinking of the Modi government, as he wouldn't have reacted so sharply without the Prime Minister's concert. As expected by the analysts, the very next day the Prime Minister Narendra Modi has come out with such strong warning of war, though short-term, appears inevitable in prevailing circumstances. The debate was on repeated ceasefire violations by Pakistan Army as well former president of that country, who was also the Army Chief General Musharraf's confession that his country indeed engaged in inciting violence in Jammu and Kashmir in a bid to help their Pakistan brethren there. General Musharraf, who himself is in trouble for treachery by his own country's apex court, especially in the case of former Pakistan Prime Minister Benazir Bhutto, was also instrumental in Pakistan's adventure in Kargil, which ensured India inflicted enough humiliation as it did in 1971 Bangladesh War. Pakistan suffered three wars and suffered defeats. If the first one was soon after independence in 1947-48 and managed to occupy part of Kashmir, which is known as Pakistan-occupied Kashmir, the next was in 1971 when the Prime Minister Indira Gandhi taught Pakistan a lesson by creating East Pakistan into a new republic country, Bangladesh. After that, it was General Musharraf who made an adventure in 1999 and his army got bloody nose. Notwithstanding the fact that whole world has come to recognize Pakistan as a rogue state, some of its retired generals continue to harp on threatening India to beware of their country as a nuclear nation. This, in spite of more Indian retired army personnel reminding their counterparts that international nuclear treaty restrained using nuclear weapons only as deterrent, falling on their deaf ears. Will Pakistan establishment, especially military, take Narendra Modi's strong warning seriously and ensuring silence of guns, or willing to face another humiliation and embarrassment which may prove quite expensive to Pakistan this time around? That our guess is as good as yours. News Desk, Mango News.
We nominated for the Swachh Bharat movement, which by Mr. Anil Ambani, which was started by our Prime Minister Narendra Modi. I hope this is our way of